Traditional Chinese martial arts has a history as old as China. Much of its deeper meaning was suppressed during Mao's Cultural Revolution. But a few dedicated masters have carried on its legacy, keeping it alive. Long Fei Yang is one of them. But mastering Kung Fu and understanding its principles takes much more than what meets the eye.
1985年的时间吧，我当时就进入传统拳训练了。那跟着我爷爷，我们家有个少林秘籍，当时我看他那个里面记载的少林拳练习，早晨都是5点多起来，那都是可以说披星戴月的就跑到学校，第一个进学校的没有人。 武功是由你自身的苦练，苦练是第一位。你没有苦练，再聪明的人也不会成为武术家，也不会真正理解武术。苦练是其实苦是第一位。Over
the years, Long Fei followed his grandfather's instruction booklet, practicing different forms of external martial arts, which focused on physical techniques like kicks and punches. But in 1996, Long Fei's father introduced him to a family friend named Mr. Li. Mr. Li was a master of a fighting style that, in addition to strenuous physical training, also focuses on meditation, soft movements, and breathing exercises. Long Fei was not very impressed in the beginning.
我看他，我说60岁的人有什么功夫？我这20多岁很强壮，我说我几拳就把他撂，就把他搞定了。当时是这么想的了。后来呢，他看出我的心思了，说你这样子吧，你过来吧，你有什么用什么吧。那当时我说那来试试。那在过程中，我发现我的拳一稍微粘住他就一脚，我发现他的动作就变化了，很快。 你就找不到，几乎是像你跟你感觉是在一个跟影子在打，而不是跟一个人在打。那这过程中，我发现没有几分钟，我的体力就耗消耗的特别大，我就累了。然后他一稍微一接触我，一发劲的时候，我就跑到外边去几米之外。我发现我后来我悟到，我说我练的这个拳，这就是以前走过的路啊，走了走错了。 没有把真正的这个拳的精华练到，就浪费了，都练到外表上去了。我后来发现，我身体有很多不平衡，就是说从 stiff 很僵硬，从这个肌肉很发达，各方面都阻碍了我这个拳术的这个速度，还有这个练拳的一些要领。
Despite Long Fei's physical advantage, Master Li had won the fight easily, hardly using any force. Instead of relying on physical strength to attack and defend himself, Mr. Li merely followed along with and quickly redirected Long Fei's movements to his own advantage. This technique is practiced in something called internal martial arts. Mr. Li is a master of seven-star praying mantis kung fu, a style of traditional martial arts with a history of over 350 years in China. Internal martial arts, or Neijia, emphasizes soft and slow movements together with mental training. A practitioner learns to control the flow of qi, or energy, through the body with mind intent, specific movements, and meditation. Shortly after the fight, Long Fei became a student of Mr. Li. After years of practicing external martial arts, or Waijia, he gradually learned to relax and control the flow of qi through his body. Long Fei remembers the training with his teacher.
In this process, especially entering the Neijia Quan, I found that the training for 1.5 hours of the body was tiring to the point of burnout. Later, from training the skin and bones, it was flat and hard.打哪儿都不疼，打墙也不疼了。最后练放松下来，那一个站桩一个动作要练一个小时，有时候两个动作三个动作就练四个小时，这样的过程是很大的转变。那我身体呢变化也很大。第三个更利用这个武术啊，筋骨武术呢，提升自己身心啊统一。达到一种更高的境界，磨练自己。那你的境界在这个程度的，你的武术也会提高。
After years of training with Mr. Li, Long Fei mastered the system, and started to think about how to help spread the benefits of the practice to others.
Hello, 我来到美国，移民到美国之后呢，我发现这边，尤其在纽约。就是人们的生活，因为纽约是世界之都嘛，可以说是世界的一个中心，文化中心。发现这里的人呢，他们就是生活蛮压力蛮大的，人匆匆忙忙。那我就开始试着就开始教中国武术。我说我这自己这么喜欢练这么多年武术，我说为什么我不去教呢？很多外国人在教武术，我说我去开始办班，我也开始教。没想到一教呢，就教起来了。
Michael DeBarry is a practicing doctor in New York and is one of Long Fei's older students. He uses the martial arts training as a way to relax from the hectic city life. But learning internal martial arts was not easy for Michael in the beginning.
I've never done anything like that. So when I first started, I could barely do 2 minutes. And eventually got to 5 minutes. And then with Long Fei constantly pushing me to do it, you know, against my will, I learned to love it. So it's tough in the beginning. But then what happens is, when you get used to it, and your body gets used to doing it, the feeling is like a very warmed up feeling in your body. Your body becomes very loose and more efficient, it feels like. You're deep breathing, you're breathing to a certain part of your abdomen. You feel more mental clarity.And just stronger.
在西方啊，我们都是有一种好像体能竞技哈，比如像 UFC 啊，那个 MMA 啊，这些他们认为啊，能把人打倒了就算是武功很好啊。我觉得不是这样的，因为武术它有更高的境界。
Here in America, you may go into a place that they do martial arts, and you'll right off the bat, you'll learn how to punch and kick. Whereas in China, or even with this martial arts, you'll start slowly with breathing, and then you learn some basic movements. So they put a heavy emphasis on learning the basic components of the martial art, and you only progress when you master those. And so that could take years. I've been doing this for 6 years, and you might even say I'm only an intermediate or advanced beginner.
The initial exercises of traditional martial arts might seem simple and mundane at first, but the genius of it hides beneath the surface. Mr. Cooper took his first Chinese martial arts lesson in 1968 and has been practicing since.
He says it's like an ABC thing, that if you just stand and do nothing but standing, once you get what the standing does, then if you start to move,then you add B, but you no longer have to think about A. So once you've learned how to do A and B, then you go to C, but you no longer really have to think too much about doing A and B. They're just part of you. They're natural. They're not a big deal. So you can really study C and not worry about, oh, now I got to do A and B and C together, because you've learned how to do them.
Discipline 很安静，去很有耐心的去承受你这个痛苦的过程，学习提升自己的。那很多人就是愿意啊，我来学习了，我什么时候能变成布鲁斯里几个月，然后或者我学了就马上就成了太极 master 拿到 certificate， 这种都是比较不现实，而且背道武术这个真理吧。
After the student has gone through a long period of training his posture, stance, breathing, focus, and balance, an exercise called pushing hands.Is introduced in the practice.
都是为这过程中呢，使人体更好的去配合，在竞技中呢，更好的了解对方的内劲和动作的变化，自己的内劲和这个经络呢，各方面呢更敏感。
Pushing hands originally came from Tai Chi, which describes it as giving up oneself to follow another.When students practice together, it's like a form of question and answer. The student doing the pushing is asking the question, and the student receiving should answer by being soft and slow moving, without resistance.
One of the unique things about the mantis form that Lung Fei teaches is that because a lot of mantis forms can be very external, but his lineage and his school, it was one where the internal martial arts were kind of fused into the mantis. So there's a lot of Xing Yi and Tai Chi and Bagua movements within the mantis. So to me, it's a very kind of accessible version of the mantis, while other ones that are more external, I probably would not be very interested in learning.
Lung Fei also teaches Tai Chi, which he learned from his own grandfather at an early age in China. Tai Chi is also an internal form of martial arts. Despite different outward appearances, Tai Chi and seven-star praying mantis are actually quite similar. The main difference is that Tai Chi started as an internal cultivation practice,and later became a type of martial arts. While mantis started as a form of combat, but later incorporated internal and mental exercises into the training.
I come home from a day's work.And I'm exhausted and stressed out. I do the internal training. It's like for 20, 30 minutes, it's like I recharge my battery.
身体需要一个 break， 就是说你一定要有一定的时间休息，一定要时间吃饭、睡觉、运动，还有工作。那人们应该更花一点时间和可以说花一点资金呢在修炼或者在运动或者在养生方面，那自身的一个习惯没有改变和生活的方式没有改变，认识没有改变，那它还是没有多大的效果，会带来更多的社会问题。就代表一种蒸蒸向上，带给人一种希望，一种面对困难和生活的一种不屈的精神。在这过程中，是人一种升华的过程。我觉得这是最重要，在修炼武术、体会人生的一种方式吧。 它是帮人达到最高境界平衡升华的一种状态。尤其呢，武术有这么多年的这几千年的文化在后面。莉亚他们有时候见了也会说啊，师父，那我就讲，那在美国这段时间训练呢，这几年待过，我觉得，那我其实虽然是他们的老师师父，但是我觉得没有把他看得那么重，像以前，就是说在过程中是彼此之间的认识，让他们了解中国的文化的就博大精深，它里面深奥的内涵，让他感觉他能够学到更好的一方面的文化，这是我的目的。那在过程中，在国外呢，我发现呢，在中国的方式又不一样，因为外国人他的这个思维与历史背景和文化习俗是不一样，他们对你好像是又是 friend， 又是你是老师。那在像我们一些去中国旅游啊，我就会告诉他们，你都见到中国的师傅应该怎么样行礼，应该哪些要注意，说话要哪些该说，哪些不该说。
啊，这个手这里。啊 ，OK，All right。OK. All right.
对
Grab.
OK. So we would start at 7 in the morning, and we would finish sometimes at 6 at night, and we would do that for 7 days in a row. And so I would say, the most I got out of my time there was being kind of mentored by these masters and overseen by Master Lee.He would periodically take everybody aside and everybody would stop what they're doing and we would follow him. And he would teach us how to do the movements and critique us and then we would go back to training separately with the other master.